Welcome to the coolest stuff on the planet.
Hey guys, and welcome to the podcast. This is the coolest stuff on the planet. I'm here with my co-host, Rachel.
Woo!
Yes, how you doing, Rachel?
Excellent, how are you?
Great.
All right, well, today we're going to check out the Niagara Falls. Sort of. It's just a pretext, actually. Mostly, we're going to talk about why people are obsessed with doing scary, crazy, insane things over waterfalls.
And they appear to be. Lots and lots of people do crazy, insane things over scary, scary waterfalls.
Yes, indeed. Especially at Niagara Falls for some reason.
Exactly.
So Niagara Falls is located both in Canada and the United States. So this is a little binational or multinational little journey that we're taking.
Sure, call it multinational.
Yeah. You've got the Niagara River, which flows through both. And then on the east bank, you have Niagara Falls, New York. Mm-hmm. On the west bank, you have Niagara Falls, Ontario.
Yes, and it's actually made up of three waterfalls. So you've got the Horseshoe Falls on the Canadian side, the American Falls on the American side, and the Bridal Falls, which actually are, it's kind of part of the American Falls, but it's split off by this little, what do you call it?
It's just by a little island.
Yeah, a little island thing. The Horseshoe Falls, it's actually been the site for most of the daredevil activities.
So for a little bit more perspective on how big Horseshoe Falls is, it's a vertical drop of about 170 feet, and that's just down to the water, to the pool, not down to the base of the pool, actually.
Yes.
That's much deeper. And the bulk of the river actually flows over Horseshoe Falls.
Mm-hmm.
About 90% flows through Horseshoe Falls and about 10% flows through the American Falls.
Okay, so let's get into the crazy, colorful history of adrenaline junkies, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you've got some famous daredevils, specifically the Great Blondin. He walked a tightrope over the Niagara Falls from the U.S. side to the Canadian side. He did it for the first time in 1859, and then he did it 8 more times after that.
But not to be outdone, his rival, who is called the Great Farini,
oh yes,
aka William Leonard Hunt, he did the same thing in 1860, mm-hmm. but he took it to a whole new level.
What did he do?
So he walks across the same way on the tightrope with mm-hmm. the balance bar, but he attached a second rope to his back, right?
Okay.
So he walks across, he's in the middle, mind you, balanced, you know, hundreds of feet above this rushing river, mm-hmm. these falls. And at the midpoint, he lowers himself down 200 feet to a tourist boat, has a glass of wine, all nonchalant, raises himself back up, and then finishes his journey.
So then you have the barrel people. Okay, so in 1901, first person ever to go over the falls inside a barrel was Annie Edison Taylor, a 63-year-old former school teacher. And she went over in a pressurized barrel that was stuffed with pillows, an anvil for a ballast, and her cat for company.
There were other crazy folks that followed her example, about 15 other people, actually.
Mm-hmm.
And the most recent one was in 2003, a guy named Kirk Jones. He decided to forgo the barrel, jump into the river,
this man is
float
crazy.
Down and over the side.
See, I don't think
he
realized.
Lived.
I don't think he realized that the falls were there. And then, oh, whoops. Nothing you can do.
Well, it's pretty amazing, though, I think, that he survived, and other people who actually did go over in barrels didn't make it.
If you want to learn more about these 16 daredevils, check out the article, How Going Over Niagara Works. It's on our website, howstuffworks.com.
And we would be remiss if we didn't mention some non-daredevil stuff.
Yes.
So some other coolest stuff at Niagara Falls. At night they have light shows.
Mm-hmm.
They light up the American Falls and the Canadian Falls. It's supposed to be pretty beautiful.
Yeah.
Obviously you have a waterfall, so during the day, there's a lot of mist.
Yeah.
Which creates lovely rainbows.
It does. Rainbows. You know those boat rides that we were talking about, the one that the Great Farini landed on?
Uh-huh.
They're actually tourist boats that are still active right now. And then there are observation decks and towers for great views of the falls if you don't want to get a little mystified down there. Mystified, get it?
Okay, so that is Niagara Falls. But if you'd like to learn a little bit more about it, whether it be about the falls themselves, getting there, daredevils. There's actually a fantastic article on the site by Mr. Chuck Bryant.
Chuckles!
Of Stuff You Should Know fame. Chuckles. I thought it was Chuckers.
Either way.
Oh yeah, he has lots of names. Mm-hmm. Anyway, called How Daredevils Work.
It's on our website, howstuffworks.com.
For more on this and thousands of other topics, visit howstuffworks.com. And let us know what you think. Email travelpodcast@howstuffworks.com. Don't forget to check out our other podcasts, free on iTunes.